All right, all right, all right. It's time to get started. We're going to give our people a second to roll in today. Hit them with a little "This Is How We Roll." This is Uplift with Cliff, and I am hyped today. It is September the 14th. It's a beautiful month, and my people are rolling in. Good morning, good morning, good morning. We're hitting them with a little Florida Georgia Line, and no, I don't own the rights to this music, as they say, but holla at your boy. We're going to get started today. I got so much to talk about. I got something that I promised that I was going to do. And we're going to get to it today. So while our people are rolling in, they're coming in slow because I let them in slow. It's 9:30 a.m. September the 14th. This is Cliff Long. I am here today, your host with Uplift with Cliff. And we're beginning the day with a little bit of Florida Georgia Line. This is how we roll. If you never jam with these boys, you need to. Okay, y'all about ready to get started? Ah, look at there, look at there. Good morning, Marta. Anita Coletti. Lisa Hill. Look at my people. President Reese. Anna Gazzara. My angel there, I'm going to mention you a big shout out later on today, Anna Gazzara. I see you, Jamie Glover. I see you, Rose Kemp. Wendy Torres, te amo you. All right. I got to get started today. I don't have a lot of time. We've got executive committee meeting later on today, so I will have to hit the music a little bit later on, okay? So y'all give me a little bit of grace today. I got a couple of things that I want to share with you today, and one of them is a super duper high profile, knock 'em, kill 'em, rock 'em, sock 'em robots Facebook page for something that we're going to talk about a little bit later on. Jorge, good morning, my brother. Will Laval, Kyuyin, Duong, Natalie. Look at Natalie, Demetra, Wendy, Patty, Elaine. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Hey, make sure you get ready to hit that share button. Today, I'm going to tell y'all a little bit more about Cliff. Some things that you've never heard before. Some things that probably won't shock you because many of you know me by now. But all you uplifters out there, today this message is for you because I want you to uplift, uplift, uplift. I don't ever want you to stop uplifting and lifting people up. I see some people, you know, lifting people up and making them feel good about themselves. So the best way I can do that is just to tell you a little bit about myself, a little bit about my past, and what does it really mean to be an uplifter. So today, I want to talk to you guys about building something called networks of good. Networks of good. Y'all put that down because this week I want you to either formalize your existing network of good or I want you to go out and start a network of good. Now, the purpose of this is it's going to enhance your business. You're going to find out that if you just do this little thing, it's going to, at the very first appearance, take you outside of what you do normally. But it's going to eventually pay off in the long run because it's actually going to enhance your life. Good morning, Diane. So I want to talk to you guys about establishing a network of good. Now, before I can do that, I got to go back into my past and tell you about my different networks of good that I started, that we still somewhat keep going, that have made all the difference in my life, both personally and professionally. So walk with me as we go back. Walk with me as we go back. I'm going to take you guys back probably about 15 to 16 years ago when a little guy named Cliff Long lived in Pensacola, Florida. Now, I don't know if you've ever been to Pensacola. If you haven't, you missed it. Some of the world's most beautiful beaches. Good morning, Carol Ann. Yes, Maria Alejandra, one of my angels, network of good. But this is the days back in Pensacola when I was just this normal little guy working for the state of Florida. And I hadn't joined the Realtors yet. And I'm not going to give you the full transition, but back in those days, I used to work and do a lot of volunteering for the church. And in those days, when I did a lot of volunteering for the church, I became quite an expert at what we would call evangelizing. And that meant literally getting out in the streets, knocking on people's doors. I was that guy. I was not a Jehovah's Witness, but I would be right there competing with them for your soul every Saturday morning, just talking to people out in the streets, meeting people, talking to people. And eventually, these people who I was out there trying to talk to about one thing would lead me to another thing. Good morning, Yannette. This is where creating a network of good actually began to pay off in my life. And I was relentless with it. I mean, I loved evangelizing. I would knock on your door if I caught you out in the streets. I'd have the Bible in my hand. Whatever it took to get the job done, I was doing it. And I had mission number one. I was going to get you in that church on Sunday morning. I remember one day, just to tell you a story, when there's this guy I met, and he told me, he promised me he was going to come to church with me, and I was trying to get everybody to come to church. I loved it when I would walk in church, and I had like a following, a brood, 50 people that I had invited, and this guy didn't show up. And man, I got upset because he didn't show up. So what did I do? I went and knocked on his front door, and his wife came, and she just looked at me like, what you doing here? She opened that door. Y'all listen to me. I walked right in that man's house, through his house, into his kitchen where he was frying chicken on a Sunday morning. I told him, you told me you coming to church with me. Put the skillet down. I made him turn the oven off, put the chicken to the side, follow me all the way out there. And I walked him all the way to that church where he got baptized that same Sunday. Creating a network of good. I soon became known as that guy around town. I would witness to people at the gas station. I would witness to people on the streets, whatever it took to create it. And this network of good, that's where I got my first global experience working with people globally. Gosh, it was at the pump one morning from Australia. And as he was sitting there pumping, I listened to his accent. I started talking to him. He told me he was on his way to Miami. I said, you're not going to Miami today. You're going to stay one more day here with me. I hijacked him and took him to church with me the next day. I would do whatever it took to get people to that point. And from learning how, good morning, precious, from learning how to communicate with people, how to listen to people, how to overcome objections in that, it made me an expert salesman. You see, that network of good where I focused, here it comes, this is the big message, where I focused my attention on helping someone else other than helping myself, I developed a skill set that made me an expert closer and an expert salesperson in another life. But it was only when I was out there trying to do good, you got it, Doc, you got it, brother. Only when I was out there trying to do good did I develop the skill set that I would need to professionally help me move forward. So some of us have things and our businesses aren't working. The money's looking funny. You're doing something strange for some change. But what you really need to do is switch up your game. Develop a network of good out there that you're doing for other people that will eventually reflect back in your business and give you needed skill sets that you're missing right now. Good morning, Matthew. So next I want to talk about one more experience. So I eventually moved from Pensacola to a beautiful little town called Gulf Breeze. Gulf Breeze, Florida. It's a beach community. The kids there are called Breezers. The houses are all pastel. You got water. It was my house, a golf course in the water. So life's looking better. Cliff's moving up. He ain't broke no more. And now we in Gulf Breeze. And guess what? I went right back to talking to people at the gas pumps, right back to talking to people, doing what was causing me to meet people and doing what was helping me develop skill sets. Good morning, Aaron. And guess what? I started talking to people out in Gulf Breeze, Florida. Look it up on the map. It's in Northwest Florida. It's a peninsula. Beautiful town. I'm out in Gulf Breeze, Florida, and I'm talking to people one more time. I'm trying to help them, and I would be running into these people at Walmart, running into them out at the soccer field, running into these people out on the streets, and I would be trying to help them with their lives. And while I was trying to help them with their lives, once I was done with them, I didn't have anywhere else to take them. They would see what happened was when they would leave me, they would go back to their regular lives. And so I went back to the church I attended, and I told the pastor, good morning, Diane. I told the pastor, I said, hey, look, I'm meeting these people. I'm witnessing to them, but, you know, church is too far. What do I do? The pastor looked at me, and he said, well, you start the church. Huh? Yeah, you start the church, Cliff. If you're running into people out there, now I need y'all to understand something. Gulf Breeze, Florida was 98% white and 2% other, and other means anybody else. So I was in an extreme minority, and here I am with this pastor telling me, hey, Cliff, you go to church, you out there witnessing people, you're telling them about the good news of Christ, and you know what, why don't you do this? You start the church. He didn't give me a dime. He didn't give me no money. He didn't give me no building. He didn't give me no keys. He didn't give me no offering. He just said, go, 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 you do it. Me, my wife, my family, my kids, I started running off papers. I went and made copies. I went door to door. I told everybody in the neighborhood, we're going to have an old-fashioned church at my house. And from that old-fashioned church in my house, I invited everybody to my house on Sunday. We packed it out. Eventually, we had to go to another location and another location. Eventually, other churches started trying to close their doors because we were taking members, and they were showing up at our house and our church on Sundays. We packed it out. That whole you can't do it. I love it when somebody tells me what I can't do. I love it because I know. Now, this network of good, we started working with people because people were on the streets. They didn't have jobs. They didn't have homes. They were struggling. Some of those people, to all my uplifters, are on this call today. Some of these people you hear me give shout-outs to, these are uplifters who we've worked with in the past just by establishing a network of good. We used to sit down, and I used to have this little slogan, give God 90 days. And we would put people's business plans. We would sit down with just people from the community. We put 3M sheets on the walls, and they would put their 30-day plans, their 60-day plans, and their 90-day plans. And we would say, we would turn your life around in 90 days. And we created REALTORs. Yes, I worked for the REALTORs back then. We created REALTORs. We created business owners. We created people who opened their own hair salons. Just by creating this network of good, we were changing lives. And my life was growing at my job. And the legend, the myth, all the stuff around my name was growing at my job. And we were doing awesome things. Today, I want you to go out and establish a network of good. Do something for someone other than yourself and watch it enhance your business. Today, this is the secret to the sauce, y'all. I'm trying to help you. I'm trying to help you understand where the popularity came from, where all this came from. The network of good, going out there and helping people help themselves. We created so many realtors, so many business people. We helped them take exams, insurance people. And such were some of you. After that, look. Things kept on growing, and they started bringing me to congressmen. They started bringing me to elected officials. We helped people turn their lives around. I remember one time, I hear you, Rose Kemp. I remember one time we reached out to the truth. This is what RPAC did. RPAC, the Realtor Political Action Committee, gave me a relationship with the sheriff in Santa Rosa County. Now, we're not in Escambia. We're moving on up. We're at the beach. We're at Santa Rosa County now. And I went to the sheriff, and I said, hey, sheriff, listen. Now, at this time, I'm still the CEO of the Realtors in the Panhandle. So at this time, I'm talking to the sheriff, and I said, hey, listen, if you ever have anybody near my house, we started this little ministry, and I told him the name and what we were doing. I said, if you ever have anybody around my house that needs help, or they're drunk driving or something like that, I said, don't arrest them, Sheriff. Just call me. What did I do that for? Ladies and gentlemen, this is where I got my first dose of loving law enforcement and understanding what they do. My phone rings at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock at night. It's the sheriff's deputies. They say, hey, Cliff, we got one for you. Cliff, we got another one. I would have to get up out of my bed at 11 and 12 o'clock. This is where I got my love of police officers and understanding what they do. I would have to get out of my bed. 11 o'clock, it's raining. And here comes somebody. And when that somebody got pulled over, they said, hey, you can go to jail. And that guy just says, do you know Cliff Long? Call Cliff Long. And the deputies would call me. And I would get up. They called me Pastor Cliff back then. But I would get up and go pick him up, drive him, and sit down with him at Waffle House. There you go, Ruth. Ruth, you got it. Stop being afraid of what could go wrong and think of what could go right. I would go pick these people up. They would be drunk. I'd sit down with them at Waffle House all night long, pumping eggs and coffee in them. And then after they were sobering up, I'd drive them down to the Holiday Inn, put them in a bed, take their keys, meet them at 7 a.m., give them their keys back, get in my car, and drive 40 miles to the Association of Realtors to be CEO. Networks of good. These people turned their lives around. Eventually, they changed their lives. Eventually, now they're professionals. They just needed a hand up and not a hand out. They needed somebody to believe in them, somebody who was willing to go down in the dump and pull them out. And my family and the church members, we did that. A network of good. I need you guys today to stop focusing on what's wrong with your business and focus on what you're not doing in other areas. Do that and watch your business prosper. We turn things around. At one point in time, it was growing so big. This is a true story. I don't like to mention names because when people ask me to do stuff, they want it to be done in silent. But the Florida Speaker of the House, because I was also in politics and in RPAC and things of that nature, the Florida Speaker of the House heard what we were doing and came and met me personally, wanted us to open up and do what we were doing in other places in his district. He wanted us to turn people's lives around, work with them, turn your whole life around in 90 days. Today, these people are realtors. Today, these people own businesses. They own hair salons. Today, these people own clothing stores. They just needed someone to believe in them for a moment. Ladies and gentlemen, I need you to know I believe in you. I believe in the good you can do. And I know that if I did that, how much more can you do? You haven't even reached your full potential yet. And all you got to do is to get to that point, stop focusing solely on your business. How much time I got? I got 15 minutes left. Stop focusing solely on your business. Go out there and start developing a network of good where you're helping other people get their life in order and watch your business take off. But remember, there's two parts of you you got to feed. You got to feed that public guy. You got to feed your spiritual guy. What happens is you're feeding that other one, but spiritually you become malnourished. You got to go out and help somebody. Today, this is all about helping people. This uplift today, a network of good. I want you to develop a network of good. I'm going to transition a little bit. So fast forward this tape, fast forward this CD, fast forward this song, and we move all the way from, I see you, Rosie. I see you, Wendy. Yes, my heart melted too. Listen, we move all the way to Orlando, Florida, and guess what? It's global, 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 global. I got people from everywhere. We're all over the world. We're traveling, and I had to develop a new network of good. Now, so I was chatting with some of my directors this week, and they told me, Cliff, just tell the story. Cliff, just come on out with it. And so there's some things that I've always kept secret, and then there are other things that, like, many of you never knew that I work with the church. Many of you never knew that I've launched multiple churches and ministries, and we've used our money to finance missionaries all over the world. From Madagascar, we made preachers and pastors and ministers in Madagascar so that we could put churches in there. All over the world, that's where a lot of our money has gone, my personal dollars and my family, towards financing ministries. So, in helping people in other areas. So fast forward to Orlando, we're in global. Now, we are in, I find myself in South and Central America because that's where our members are. Good morning, Gladys. I find myself in South and Central America. And when you become CEO, in particular of Orlando, let me tell you, you're going to get approached by some people. And these people come to you for all sorts of nefarious reasons. But they don't know me very well. I've met people, in my first introduction in South America, and a lot of my people here who are in South America now will testify to this because Maria Alejandra and Anna, they always tell me, hey, look, you can't save everybody. You got to not be used. But people would bring different people to me. In particular, I would get approached by whether it be drug people or whether it be people trafficking sex, they come to me, they hear CEO, and they come running right up to you. Good morning, L. And you have to learn how to handle this. Well, it came time for the next network of good. I reached out to some of my directors, both MLS and ORRA, and people would bring these people to me, and I would take them directly to my members. I learned all sorts of things. One of the things I learned about how in South America and Colombia, they had cartels. And these cartels would literally take women and enhance their bodies, and then they make sex slaves out of them. And then they put them out there, and these women, their job is to go out and make money. And it's a heart-wrenching thing because these are some of the most beautiful people in the world. And then they approach you, or the guy or their handler approaches you. Well, how do you turn that around? What do you do with that? Well, I reached out to some of my directors, especially those who understand how to speak Spanish. And guess what? We took those people that were being brought to us in other countries. I introduced them to a lot of my realtors. And my realtors, I got some angels out there who were on this call today. I asked them specifically to be here. They would tell me, Cliff, we can help this one. Cliff, we can't. I learned about visas, all the effects of Washington, D.C. on other countries, how you move people around, the cost of hiring an attorney, how do you help people in other countries. Listen, we're on the streets of Dubai, and these three boys, they approach me. And as we're in Dubai, these young men are approaching me. They're trying to sell me things, and I'm looking at them, and I'm saying, hey, if you can hawk things out here on the street, how much more could you do if you were a realtor? So while they're trying to sell me, I'm reaching out to the realtors in Dubai, and I'm networking, bringing these guys in, connecting them. And guess what? They reached out to me a couple of days ago to say, hey, Cliff, look, we got our own store. We're on our way to learn how to be realtors. We want to thank you for what you did, enhancing what we do here at Orlando, creating a network of good. You see, a lot of times people don't understand what it means to get in deep with people, to go undercover, to talk to people. But a lot of my directors found out I would go get these people, bring them directly to them, and say, hey, can you help? It's modern day evangelizing. Yes, Anna, all we need to do is listen and not judge. Listen, Anna Gazzara, that's one of my angels. Anna travels with me a lot with Global and makes sure that I don't get approached by these different women and people. She's one of my bodyguards. She and a couple of other people, Maria Alejandra, Mary, they always make sure that I'm okay. But they tell me, this one can be helped. Cliff, this one just wants to take your money. Cliff, this one wants to use you. But we created our own network of good, helping people who wanted to be helped in other countries turn their life around. And such were some of you. And such are some of you. Some of the very people that you see walking around Orlando on these streets are these people. Some of the very people that you run into, they started businesses. All they needed was help getting out of the country, help escaping a situation, help escaping a pimp, help escaping a person. But if you won't ever get your hands dirty and make that witness to the person at the gas pump, knock on their door, or go pull them out of their own kitchen, you'll never know it. One of the things that I love is my directors have had my back since I've got here. And they make sure that, you know, I involve them, and they've always had my back. A lot of people don't know about the work that ORRA does in other areas. A lot of people don't know that we support other boards and that we've been reaching out to them all through the crisis to make sure that they're okay. A lot of people don't know that we haven't abandoned anyone. And even the kids on the street that we met at Dubai a year ago are still reaching out to ORRA to this day because we were the first group or persons to ever help them. Maria Alejandra, Anna, we've been in the back door, some places. I remember we went into one store where they opened up a secret compartment, and then we walked in, and then they opened up another secret compartment, and we went into that one, and then there was a sliding door. We have been deep in the dark jungles of these places, all to meet people and to help people. Patty, I love it. How can you volunteer? Join our Global. Now, this is not the mission of Global. This is just one of the things that Cliff likes to do when he's out there helping people. Anna, Anna's laughing because she remembers the stories. Anna receives all these people I bring to Orlando and whatnot, and she starts talking to them. The point of the matter is today, all my uplifters, this week, I want you to go out and make up your mind that you're going to do good, not just for yourself, for your business, but for other people, because they're depending on you. And the situation and the circumstance that you've been given, that you're in, was not just meant to fill your pocketbook, but to help other people. Always let your light shine on other people and not just yourself. I know, Rosa, you've always had my back, especially when we travel. A lot of people don't understand what we do when we travel. A lot of people think it's just about that. But if the Lord puts somebody in my path that needs help, I'm going to go get them. I meet all sorts of people, and you can't go pull somebody out of the mud if you ain't going to get your feet dirty and your hands dirty. When you meet those people, you can't just buy the purse or buy the jewelry. You're there to help them. You can't, if you run into a woman and she's trying to sell her soul or her body to you, you don't take it. I take those people and introduce them to my realtors, and my realtors take it and run with it. And we've been beautiful at this for years. Yes, Anna. So today, this is all about, I want all my people out there to set up and do a network of good. Who are you helping other than yourself in your community and your church, at the YMCA, at the Boys and Girls Club? Because if you do that, that thing is going to enhance everything else that you do, and your business will take off, your community presence will take off, and that's the legend of Si Se Puede. We can do anything if we just set our mind towards it. Reese says, have a great day, everyone. And so now, we're getting ready to transition, and I've got something special. So a lot of you guys reached out to me, and we know that COVID-19 is the name of the virus. But listen, today I'm going to talk about the 19 pounds that you gained because of COVID. So many of us out there have sat at home and just gained weight. Berliza, mi abogado, the attorney in Panama. Good morning. It is good to see you. I know you do good. I've seen the good you do right there in Panama. Listen, today this is about, I want to do something special for you. So all over the internet, whether you're on Instagram or on Facebook, you see pictures of people working out, getting healthy. So I thought about this. I thought about all my uplifters, but not just the uplifters, all of the people in Orlando Realtors and Acobir, Berliza y Acobir. We created a Facebook page, and it's called Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. I waited until now because I didn't want you to click over and go to the page. You can join Orlando Realtors Getting Fit, and I am opening up Pandora's box. This is for you guys. It's time for us to be accountable. I'm going to hold everybody accountable. I want to see your workout videos. I want to see you getting in shape. I want you guys to upload every day. I want you to blow the internet up. I'm going to put together a little bitty contest. And with this contest, we're going to measure weight loss and BMI. And who knows, I may throw a vacation in. I may throw a trip in. I might ask President Reese for some free ORRA dues. But this is where I want all our realtors to daily put your workout videos, put your workout recipes, put your diet. I want everything that you can give me on Orlando Realtors Getting Fit, the Facebook page. Yes, Doc, we're going to uplift and we're going to get fit at the same time. Look at Rose Kemp on her workout walk. Rose Kemp, from now on, I want you to turn that camera on, upload that workout walk, and then I want you to upload it to Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. I want the world to see you working out, Rose. Doc, I want the world to see you. We're going to lose weight together. Can we lose 1,000 pounds? Yes, can we lose 1,000 pounds? Today, this is my challenge. I want us to lose 1,000 pounds of unhealthy fat with the realtors. Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. I see you, Doug DeVitri, my man in St. Louis. Yes, Demetra says she's on day 74 of a workout. I knew this existed. I knew our members because I follow you elsewhere and you follow me. It's time now that we got fit together. I want all my uplifters to go to Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. That's the name of the Facebook page. Join it, and I'm going to maybe appoint one or two administrators, and I want you to upload your videos. Now, listen, folks. We all know some of you look good, and when you look good, you want people to see everything. Don't hurt them. Don't be on there trying to hurt them. Don't show them everything and make me have to shut the page down. This is about working out. It's about getting fit. I want to see your diet. Hey, no hating whatsoever. If there's any hate on the page, I'm going to block you and cut it off. This is a positive page. We're going to upload our workouts. Berlisa, make sure that all my people in Acobira in Panama know that this page exists. I want them on it. I want all my uplifters, I want you guys out there letting folks to know, join this Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. I promise you, I'm not going to try to sell you ads on it. I'm not going to try to sell you things on it. I just want to interact with you. We're going to hold each other accountable. You'll see my workout. I'll post things. I'll post motivational messages. But I want you to post yourself to that site too. Okay, it's 9:58. I have about 2 minutes left. And I've told you more. We're going to go back to, I'll tell you more about I'll talk to you more about a network of good later on, because I'm going to give you some more testimonials from other realtors. But I want you guys to, let's close out our day. We're going to do our usual affirmations, okay? The first thing we're going to say to ourselves today is, today I will be successful. Today I will be successful. Today I will be successful. Today, I will be successful. I want you to say this with me. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I want you to say this with me. God loves me and I love God. God loves me and I love God. Say this with me. I am a successful business owner. I am a successful business owner. Say it. This year, my business will take off. Yeah, you got to believe it. Listen, I can't say it for you. You got to say it for yourself. Say it. This year, my business will take off. Say, I am a great mother and my children love me. I am a great mother and my children love me. I am an awesome father and my children love me. Yes, Matthew, you will be successful today. Say it. Say, today, I will add 3 new clients. Today, I will add 3 new clients. Say, today, this is going to be my best day ever. This is going to be my best day ever. You need to say it to yourself. Today will be my best day ever. You got to say it. I can't say it for you. You got to say it for yourself. Today will be my best day ever. I want you to say it. This business will never be the same once I'm done with it. This business will never be the same once I'm done with it. This business will never be the same once I'm done with it. And you guys know our signature phrase. I want you to say it with me. Say, I'm the best you ever met. I am the best you ever met. I believe that. You believe that. It's 10 o'clock, folks. Today is executive committee meeting at ORRA. And I can't stick around you any longer because President Reese is going to have my hype. I need you to know something, Claudia. I love you. President Reese loves you. This is going to be your best week ever. This is going to be the best day ever. This is going to be the best moment ever. I'm here to tell you that you are awesome. And the only way you can be beat is if you quit. So don't quit. Don't quit. Don't you ever quit. You are loved. This is going to be your best week ever. And before I let you go, I'm going to close out letting you know one more thing. Remember what I always say. Thoughts become things. It's been Uplift with Cliff, September 14th. I love you. Thoughts become things. Yes, Erin, you're an awesome mother. Yes, Maria Alejandra, the best I ever met. Wendy Torres. Yes, Carol Ann Burnett, you are. We're helping people out there. Never let your good be evil spoken of. You're an awesome mother. Anna Gazzara, thank you for being my angel in the streets. Claudia, take care. Quinn, you are a successful business owner. You guys got it. Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. Go join today. Like it. It's time to upload those videos. I'll see you later. Thoughts become things.